Hey, Margaret. You creep me out, but I love you. Margaret, you creep me out, but I love you. I love you. M-A-R-G-A-R-E-T, Margaret. M-A-R-G-A-R-E-T, Margaret. So fair, oh Margaret, I love you. But oh man, you creep me out. Hey Margaret. Beans.
sponsors. The wonderful Zed Zombie and his Ashopalypse has recently opened a new location in neighboring Innsmouth, right across the street. Smith Barber Shop. Zed is running a sale a today's public service announcements. Now, for some positive affirmations. Yes, you are good. Yes, you are good. Yes, you are good. Yes, you are good. You are the peanut butter to someone's jelly sandwich. particular special individuals responsible for watching over our prized singularities. Margaret was saying, hello to Laverne, room 420. Hello, Alex, room 97. Hello, Edward Carnaby. Hello, Funk, room 666. Hello, Alex, room 966. Emily, room 147, Ziza, room 82, Julius, room 437, Medius, room 23, Axel, room 483. This reminds me of bingo night. But instead of bingo balls, we're using people. Hello, Cyan Hedeman, room 115. Hello, Aiden, room 718. Brandon, room 420. Maria, room 666. Rob, room 759B, John, room 413, Callum, room 404, Leonardo, room 913, Metal, room 13, Val, room 112, Pedro, room 4442, Louis, room 101. Melissa, room, Melissa, room 17. Zach, room 615. Pinhead, room 117. Zand, room 4. Amethyst, room 12-31. Hello, Anath, room 391. Oliver, in room 103, who also apparently has Nico 270 somewhere in or around his closet. Hello, Nathan, room 101. The patient that thinks his number is his vault number. Snatcho, room 182. Hurley, lost room number 4, 8, 15, 6. Wait a minute. Aren't you dead? Calvin, room number 3. Hello. Hello, Chris Gillespie, room 623. Rachel, room 314. Hello, Rachel. Our most prized one of our most prized residents. Suzelle, room 313. Hello. Hello, Nicholas, room 117. Ernst, in room 117. I am not sure if that's perhaps a typo, or they are both in the same room on the same number in a different ward. William D.P. Alkins, room 420. A lot of these room 420s. Oh, well, whatever plays on. Nifnoff, room 724. Popo, room 27. Josephine in room 202. Hello. Hello, Jameson Lee, room 3928. Hello, Dylan, room 712. Chin Chin in the door behind the door marked FF. Trehet, number 315. Hello. Hello, Peggy, 319. Hello, Jack, room 8. Patient in room 88, Malediktus, room number 37, Spooky, number 42, hello, hello, Balador, room 333, hello, Callie Maggotboom, room 666, one of Margaret's favorite room numbers, by the way, if Margaret had it her way, she would number all of the rooms. 666. Hello, Barkness, room 113. Hello, Yanis, room 101. Willow, room 76. Hello, Willow. Courtney, room 307. Amorphous interdimensional blob, room number -1. Eldrad, number 63. Grace, room 307. Hello. Hello, Leighton Walls, room 69. Frook, room 512. Hello. Reverend Rico, room 616. Isaac, room 500. Hello. Hello, Charlie, room 0394. Danny, room 1408. Lycaon, room 1941. Eggs, Benny, room 715. The guy in room 23 that no one ever asks about. Melanie, room number 7. Jeffrey D, room 213. Alan, LZ, room negative 28. Hello, Ira, number 72. Nick, number 5150. Scrungy, hello. The forgotten experiment in room number 151. Oscaro, room number 956. Room number 9 3/4. Patient 63, Yuki. Babylon, number 907. Hello. Runny Ron, room 666. Morgan, room 419. Hello. Hello, Lilith Sinclair, who keeps sneaking out at midnight to the patient cemetery. Disc, disc, disc. Blake Corral, room number 8008135. That can't be right. I don't think we have room numbers that go that high. Frederick in room number 104. Berenice, room 303. Hello. Grant, room 115. Hello. Bork Metal Peter, mightiest of Orc Chieftains, room 066. Hello. Hello. Ryan, room 36A. Hello, Noah B, room 666. Hello, Nick, in room 289. Hello, Ed, room 1 1/3 times 12. Hello, Shadow, in room 495. You're not alone. Hello, Solitary, room square root minus 1. Or negative 1. I always forget how that room number operates. Margaret doesn't. Math. Margaret has better things to do than to be concerned with that nonsense. Math is such an antiquated religion. I don't understand why so many still practice it. Anyway, Omar, room 409. Hello. XRQ-24 from room 37. Hello. Hello, Bloodnor, room 124. Hello, Odium, room 515. Dalton, room 1217. Dr. Lukens, room 1984. Crisis, room 142. Ross Mellow, room 314. The Traveler, room number. Sorry about that. No room number here. Alex, room 27. Hello. The ghost prototype from room 17. Alex, room 42. Caesar, room 429. Hello. Hello, Nana, room number 9. Cal, room 409. Last but not least, hello, Luke, room number 250. And of course, everyone that I did not have a chance to personally greet and say hello. Hello from Margaret. I hope that you and everyone are doing well. I know some of you may be suffering from PTSD, especially from the Great Marshmallow War, and of course, it goes without saying, the Great 1,000-Year War. So, Margaret would just like to spend a little time discussing this. I would hate to say the word, sometimes there are people out there that attach a negative association or stigma to mental illness, but in any case, post-traumatic stress disorder is a serious issue that should never be taken lightly. No. It doesn't just impact veterans of war, but also others who have dealt with other physical and mental trauma. Now, Margaret is not a psychiatrist or a psychologist or even a doctor. I am just a nurse. By title, a title I gave to myself, but I am still a nurse anyway. I know my way around a syringe and a scalpel. But as I was saying, for those out there that may be suffering with this condition, I want you to know that Margaret cares deeply for you, and you are in Margaret's thoughts. I hope that you are seeking professional treatment, and that you are on a better road to recovery and improvement and overall better well-being. Mental health has such a stigma associated with it. Many people take it for granted and associate it, again, as I have said, with a negative connotation, and they also take it lightly. Did I just say that? Margaret cannot remember. The human brain is so fascinating. And tasty, but more fascinating than anything. The human mind is such a delicate machine, such a delicate place. A place that is not fully understood by science and by those in the medical field, which is why the professor and all of his colleagues, including Margaret herself, carry out the experiments must tread lightly when it comes to matters of the mind. Parents have the greatest responsibility when it comes to raising a healthy child into a healthy adult that is able to contribute to the world in which we live. We must not abuse our children, neglect them, or constantly yell at them, or humiliate them. Children are such precious creatures that will one day grow up to be scientists or medical practitioners, nurses, doctors, astronomers, and parents as well. So we must not continue the vicious cycle of abuse that often occurs to today's children through the lack of respect and care by their parents or even by other children and adults. Human beings are more than just animals. They are not robots. They are not toys. It is important that we create a safe and peaceful, nurturing environment for children and young adults so that they can reach their true potential. Besides, we only have so many rooms here at Arkham Sanitarium. We cannot continue to keep taking in those that are neglected or abused. Although our doors are always open, some of our patients just wander off the streets. But as I was saying, we must show more respect and empathy and care and all of these positive attributes that make us, well, used to make Margaret before she was reanimated, but make you, human beings, unique and above the rest of the animal world. We must not resort to our base, or is it basal or banal? I don't know, but we must not resort to our animal, primal animal instincts, out of fear, out of anger. We must not hurt one another. We must create a more peaceful world. And why so many do not understand this or cannot comprehend it and continue to perform acts of ignorance and bigotry, hate and violence, pizza. Feeble brain, or what's left of it. And that is why, what was I saying? Oh, PTSD is one of the results of what happens to a human being's mind when it is put through such inhumane trauma and such. We must continue to promote peace and love and kindness and empathy and understanding and open-mindedness. If we are to truly reach our potential as a species, as this human race, otherwise we are no more than animals. But mental illness doesn't mean that people are crazy, as it has always been portrayed by Hollywood and so many films. Mental illness, Margaret doesn't even like that word. It is implied that someone is ill, mentally ill, and that is not necessarily true. Sometimes we are born. Margaret likes to think that we are born with this particular genetic mental makeup. And we are somewhat predestined to behave in a certain way, that it is not necessarily an illness, not something that needs to be cured, like a disease or a sickness, but perhaps we should change the way we look at how we behave, and perhaps because some of these behaviors occur so frequently that it is not necessarily an illness, but something that can be. How does Margaret? Margaret is hunting for the words. Something that we can see both the positive and negative aspects of, for instance, anxiety, depression, now it is not necessarily for words, but depression is not something that necessarily has a positive side, but have you ever noticed that most writers, artists, and creative folks suffer with depression? So whether or not it is an illness, Margaret does not believe that depression can be cured with a pill. And while we should not promote depression as something positive, and that we should relish or enjoy or revel in our depression, but that depression may have a positive aspect in so much as it may be able to be managed by seeing the positive aspects of it, although Margaret understands that sometimes depression is pure darkness and a world void of anything positive. Before Margaret was reanimated, believe it or not, Margaret herself suffered with depression. But Margaret was able to find this small little crack of light in this world of dark, this silver little lining, as they say. And that was that Margaret found a creative release that helped her through her dark days. Which, of course, helped her through this depressive period. Now, depression may not necessarily be something that we are born with, of course. It may not be a genetic trait like anxiety may be. But maybe people with anxiety are prone to have or suffer with depression at some point in their life. Aside from the fact of depression being brought about by outside external situations and circumstances and forces, the point that Margaret is trying to make is, while depression may not be the best example here, things like anxiety may have a side to them that is beneficial. The point is that there is a bright side and a dark side, black and white, yin and yang, etc., etc., to almost everything in this life, and that we must strive toward looking for the bright or the light when we are in the dark, in order to help us escape the darkness. That is what Margaret had to do before she was reanimated, or before her untimely demise, on an expedition. But now is not the time to discuss that. This does not mean that we should look lightly at such things as depression and anxiety and say that we should be happy that we have these, suffer with these things that are often crippling, because there may be a positive side. But the point is that perhaps there is a reason that some of these things lesson that we should have a more open mind, that mental illness may not always be an illness, but perhaps in cases where it may be, or may be crippling, or debilitating, that we should show enough respect for those who suffer, that they are not freaks or weirdos or anything like this. Because the real freaks and weirdos are those who would cast judgment on another human being without reading their book. Never judge a book by its cover, especially one that seems to be dark. We must all strive to grow and to improve and to become better human beings, better caretakers of the earth, better friends, better lovers, better companions, better human beings towards one another, towards all the animals on the planet, towards the planet itself. So, I hope that has helped a little bit. Margaret is not, as she stated earlier, the greatest speaker, or, of course, she's no psychologist or psychiatrist, but hopefully you understand what I was trying to convey here. Well, my friends, listeners, members of the staff, residents, watchers and viewers, and all types of creatures, thank you for joining Margaret in this inaugural episode for me as a host. I hope you enjoyed, and I hope that you have been enjoying this show. So far, we hope to continue to bring you more excitement and wonderfulness that only we can hear at this wonderful facility. Whoever you are, wherever you are, please take one moment at a time. Do not look at the whole future and then you have to rush to go here and to go there. Learn to look at your whole life and that you may live to be 70 and 80 years old, and enjoy each moment, enjoy each day, continue to strive towards being the best person that you can be, knowing that you will make mistakes, that you will learn from the mistakes, and that you might make those mistakes again and again. try your best to be patient, that you will continue to explore this world, that you will continue to learn new things and experiment and take risks. Of course, risks that do not risk necessarily your life, those you love, or your financial situation. Although sometimes your financial situation, such as your job, seeking a new job or career, could be a risk worth taking. Just make the best choices you can each day, with the best information and knowledge that you have gained from your own experiences, and continue to build upon those experiences and that knowledge so that you can evolve your mindset, your overall human persona, and always look yourself in the mirror. Remember, what you do not like in others is a direct reflection of that within yourself that you have yet to face and address. Remember to be the best that you can be, and try to make the world a better place. We all can do that. We might never need an Arkham sanitarium. Just don't tell the professor I said that, or I might get in trouble. Last time I got in trouble, he put me into the sensory deprivation chamber for a week. Although Margaret admits that was quite enjoyable, then there was the time before that where he buried me out back under in plot 77. But enough of Margaret. Thank you, my friends. And of course, welcome to all new listeners, new viewers, new residents, and long-time residents as well, loyal lifers, as we say. Take care of yourself. And Margaret has to be going. I must go see a particular patient. They had an accident, and they are currently in another location, undergoing a blood transfusion. Corvus had tried to help them.